continuing her outdoor paint projects. Now it is time to tackle the vinyl siding and the windows, right, Sharon?
Yep, Trace, you know, I get asked about it a lot, and people are always very surprised and happy that they can, in fact, paint vinyl, whether it's the siding or the windows. Now, there are some limitations, which I'll talk about a little bit later, but overall, it's such a great savings rather than replacing all of the vinyl that you actually paint it. So you want to think about the same kinds of things that we talked about for all the other exterior surfaces. You want to make sure everything is clean, everything is dry, and everything is relatively dull.
Okay, now do you have to prime vinyl before you can paint it?
Good question, Trace. In most cases, you don't have to prime your vinyl siding, but there are cases where it's really pitted or porous, and maybe it's really, really old, so then it's not a bad idea, and then I would suggest using like a Fresh Start primer, which I don't have here, but a Fresh Start primer for that. So it'll just kind of seal it. And then just go ahead with your two coats of, I tend to use Aura Exterior in a low luster for vinyl. But again, the more important thing is you think about the limitations of color. And this is something that that I want to just remind people, that vinyl is prone to warping. If in some darker colors will definitely attract the heat even more. So Benjamin Moore does have a palette of 75 vinyl safe colors that you want to think about starting from that point so that you don't have any issues with warping down the road. But when it comes to windows, I do find that they are a little bit shinier sometimes, so it's a good idea to use a specialty primer like Styx primer. I find that that is sort of more adherent, so it'll stick to that surface, again, after a really good clean. And then you can get into painting the surface with whatever color you want to use, but you want to use something with an acrylic latex, so either the Regal Select exterior or an Aura. And I tend to go a little bit more like a satin finish for the window area.
Well, so many people are doing those window makeovers because a lot of people want to go from the stark white to the black. So this is really good information for our viewers. Sharon, we received an email from a Cityline viewer named Robin who needed some help with her home exterior. So she referred to the color as newborn poop. So you hopped on a call with her to give her some advice. And I hear she had a little surprise for you. Let's take a look.
Hi, Sharon. I don't know if you remember me.
Hi, Robin.
But I joined in on your honeymoon. Do you remember that?
Oh my God.
You're that Robin.
Yeah.
Wow. That was, we were in Indonesia. We traveled around Bali and Lombok. Oh my God, it was such a small little group, and it was so crazy that there was three Canadians of all the international people. And oh my God.
I think there was five of us all together, and I was happy to take all your honeymoon pictures for you. And I think we've been talking about a few Benjamin Moore colors when we were looking at pottery and things like that.
Yes, exactly. Because I think that was the one and only time I didn't carry my fan deck with me was on my honeymoon. It was so funny when you sent in the email to Cityline asking for some help because you wanted to change the color of your existing baby poop brick. So I jumped at that. I was very happy to help you out.
Having a nursing background, as soon as I saw the color of the bricks, I thought immediately, also did my medical friends too, baby poop. I think the color that it is now dates it. And I think while we want it to look a little more modern, because we are going to be renovating inside and we're going to be having new windows.
I think I can definitely help you get rid of the baby poop. And painting the brick will be, you know, it'll be a big job, but it can make a really huge difference. You'll be surprised.
Yeah. Oh, that's great. I'm really excited about this. And so appreciate it. Thank you so much.
Okay. Newborn baby poop notwithstanding, she's in an incredible spot. And how shocked were you that she was on your honeymoon with you? That is such a small world. I love that you could help Robin with this question.
It was really nice to chat with Robin a little bit longer about what she's planning to do for the house. And overall, like a lot of us, she wants to really modernize. And I think it is such an awesome little house. Now, she did say she's not a big fan of gray. So I was kind of excited about that because I've picked up a gazillion grays over the past like 10 years. So I thought that because of that beautiful location she's in, something that's still quite neutral but in the green tones would look really nice. So I was looking at Nantucket gray, and just ignore the name. It's actually more of a green. So, you know, just don't worry. It sounds gray. She's going to be like, what? I said I don't like gray. Nantucket gray is it's a really nice greeny tone. So I think that would look great and sort of set the tone for that area and be wonderful, wonderful on the brick. Now, I think that we talked about windows, and she is planning to replace them all. So that is an opportunity to change the color. So I don't mind white windows, but I think with the look of her house, I thought a black window would be a lot more, it would just suit the house a lot more, and it would definitely be a little bit more modern. She has a black asphalt roof, which is so classic. So I really think that the black around the windows will kind of make the windows feel even larger. And then while you're at it, change the fascia and the eaves trough, which is quite easy. That's not even a custom color when it comes to those aluminum finishes.
Oh, that's going to look stunning. I like the combination of those two colors for the trim and the brick. Really nice. What about painting the siding? What do you recommend?
Right. There is a little bit of siding on the peak and on other areas of the house. So for that, I thought you could just paint it the same color, so it might feel nice and fresh. Just paint it, if you go with the Nantucket gray, paint the peak the same, and it kind of feels, again, nice and fresh. But a more traditional take is to do an accent color. So I was looking at, again, staying in the greens, and I really love the historical palette for exteriors especially, because I know how they're going to work outside. But when I did it on my rendering, I felt like it really called out that triangular shape, so I wasn't so sure. I kind of liked it being all one color. So another thing I did with the rendering was I did the entire house all Gloucester sage. So it's just sort of another look, but again, she's gonna, you know, get a sample and kind of try these things out. But I kind of like the idea of it feeling more modern by doing the siding and the brick all the same color.
Yeah, I hear you. Okay, when you're choosing a color for an exterior project, light plays a big role on the color, right? So you always have to think about that.
Absolutely, Trace. And so as much as I tried to sort of pick colors without actually being there, although I'd love to be there because it looks beautiful, so I'll try that maybe by next summer. But I think that it's really, really important. It's such a big investment when you're painting your exterior. So you can use the personal color visualizer, that software on Benjamin Moore's website, and that's what I use to sort of play around with the renderings, and it gives you a really good idea. But I always, always, always tell people with the exterior especially, get a color sample, buy the actual, you know, size and get three or four colors, and then paint them out on boards, and you can move them around. And I am not joking, I still do this on every project. I did this for my own concrete block, and I'm always surprised at how different it looks than what I thought it's going to look. So big project like your entire house, it's definitely worth the investment.
Absolutely. You don't want to make a mistake on the entire, like, the space and the volume of your house, for sure. Sharon, thank you so much. Incredible lessons and tips as always.